Oh, here we go now. Top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Cook.
We're gonna play.
Kiara, we ask 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
She will defend you.
That'll never happen. Okay, defend him, yeah. Celeste, 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Clean.
Oh. All right, Louise, talk to 100 married men. Name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Watch the kids.
Oh. Terry?
Yes, sir.
We talked to 100 married men. You married, Terry?
Me, Louise. That's my wife.
I didn't know that.
Yes.
How'd you? Woo! Terry, we asked 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Leave you alone.
Leave me alone. Quit coming over here. Terry, talk to 100 married men. Name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Well, financially. You should pay more bills.
I told you. You want her to pay your bills.
Hey, she living in my house. She got to pay bills, right?
Yeah, where did you hear that in the damn question? She living in my house, she gonna have to pay these bills. Nobody said nothing. Terry just said she don't want over there that much. Well, you done sat up there and moved her in. Pay more bills. Kiara, we ask 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Take you out to, like, restaurants, take her shopping or something.
Take her restaurants.
Don't tell me how to run my house.
Okay.
Name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Stop telling me how to run my
house. Stop telling me how to run my damn house. Come on, baby. Number six. Five. Top six answers on the board, fellas. Well, here we go, fellas. We ask 100 married men, between us, name something an ex-girlfriend was better at than your wife.
Sex.
You happy? You so damn stupid. Sex. It's on the board. We asked 100 married men, which of the seven dwarfs describes your wife in bed?
This is just to get up on the boards. Bashful?
Bashful. Bashful. Michael. Two answers, topic, Michael. You control it.
We're playing.
They're gonna play it. Yeah. There's a guy over there that this meant nothing to him. Point values are double, top six answers on the board. We asked 100 married men, if you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
Her butt.
Her butt, yeah.
Her breast.
Her breast. Corinne, all right, guys, we asked 100 married men, okay? Just say that one time. Corinne, if you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
Them lips, Steve.
Ooh. Feeling her lips. Talk to 100. If you were blindfolded, this your wife right here.
Yes, sir.
Now, we got the bosom up there, we got the hiney up there, and we got the face, everything on the face. So now, you were blindfolded. You could still identify her by feeling her what?
Her feet.
Good answer!
Her feet. All right, Cal, you can clap all you want. Ain't got no strikes. You next. If you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
This hair, Steve.
This hair. Cal, there's one answer left. Ain't no strikes on that board either. Right. Ain't nobody in here but me and you. Now, if you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
Well, you know, Steve, I gotta be respectful of my father-in-law who's in the crowd tonight, but I'm gonna have to go with her lady part, Steve.
Now, if you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
I'm gonna go with her hand.
Good answer. Her hand. Top eight answers on the board. Here we go. We asked 100 married men, what would you do if your wife's New Year's resolution was to not have sex with you for a year?
Cheat on her.
Cheat on her.
Divorce her.
Divorce.
Damn.
Pass or play?
We gonna play.
We gonna play. All right, I'm gonna say this one time. We asked 100 married men, what would you do if your wife's New Year's resolution was to not have sex with you for a year?
Start an argument. I'd argue about it.
Start an argument. No! Eric, what would you do if your wife's New Year's resolution was to not have sex with you for a year?
Steve, I think I'm gonna head to the strip club.
Uh-oh. Wow, good job.
Straight to the strip club. Should have been number one. Richard?
Yes.
What would you do if your wife's New Year's resolution was not have sex with you for a year?
Cut out the money.
Good answer. Cut off the money. Cut off the money. All right, we got to slow down now. We got two strikes. The Demarest family can steal. Mallory, what would you do if your wife's New Year's resolution was not have sex with you for a year?
Pick up a hobby.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Pick up a hobby. We asked 100 married men, what would you do if your wife's New Year's resolution was not have sex with you for a year?
Accept it. Accept her New Year's resolution.
Oh, just accept it.
Mm-hmm.
Accept it! Eight.
Negotiate. Discuss.
Seven. Five.
Lose my mind.
That's for damn show. Number four.
Do the laundry.
Top seven answers on the board. This is a good one. We asked 100 married men, if your wife left you on Saturday night, what would you do on Sunday morning?
Sleep in.
Sleep in. Sleep in.
That's the truth.
Yeah.
We're fine.
Yeah. Honey, I'm leaving you. Bye, Felicia. Bye, Felicia. What are you doing Saturday morning? I'm sleeping in. Man, I love dudes. Big Daddy Mark, we talked to 100 married men. If your wife left you sad tonight, what would you do on Sunday morning?
I'd have to get up, get dressed, go to church, brother.
Yeah.
Had to get up and go to church, man.
Good answer.
Figure out what went wrong. Natalie, if your wife left you on Saturday night, what would you do on Sunday morning?
Go golfing.
Yes.
Oh, good. That's nice.
Golf. Golf.
Good answer.
Golf. Go to golfing.
Yes!
So far, I would do all three. Well, I probably don't get to sleep in much, so. Well, let's go, Adam. Married men, if your wife left you on Saturday night, what would you do on Sunday morning?
Watch sports.
What? Man, come on. Watch sports.
Yeah.
Ladies, I don't know if you notice a pattern here, but there's not a lot of real concern so far. Seven of us then went to talk to the Lord about it, but so far the rest of us just playing golf, watching TV, and sleeping in. Wait till you see the next one, though. Vanessa, if your wife left you on Saturday night, what would you do on Sunday morning?
Get a lawyer.
Oh! Yeah, that's up there.
Nope, not yet. Don't need a... Get a lawyer.
Oh. I forgot it was Mandy.
Only one strike, Craig. If your wife left you on Saturday night, what would you do on Sunday morning?
I wouldn't, but cheat.
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah. Yeah. Cheat. Immediately. Next. Mr. Mark, we got two strikes. Peyton, family can steal. 100 men. If your wife left you sad tonight, what would you do Sunday morning?
Go to breakfast.
What do you think? Go to breakfast. Give me some pancakes and bacon and kind of work through it a little bit. You know, get double butter on it. Yeah, just go get some breakfast.
Woo! It's up there.
We asked 100 married men, if your wife left you on Saturday night, what would you do on Sunday morning?
We're gonna say, go find her.
Go find her. Number seven.
Yeah.
It'd be more than two people crying, tell you the truth. Number four. Okay, I like this question here. You ask 100 married men, I'm married. Name a household chore you love to see your wife do in the nude.
The kitchen floor. Mop the kitchen floor. That's my
good
husband down there.
Good.
Oh, that's your husband
yes.
down there.
That's my husband. Mop
oh,
the kitchen floor.
Oh, he'd love to see you mopping
mop
the kitchen floor.
Mop the kitchen floor. You got to mop the kitchen floor.
Good answer.
You got it. You got to do what?
Mop the kitchen floor. You got to mop the kitchen floor. Mop the kitchen floor.
Yay! Okay. I got news for you. I don't care what the chore is. We're going to want to see you naked doing it. Mopping the kitchen floor. Name a household chore you love to see your wife do in the nude.
Make up the bed.
Make up the bed.
That's good. Okay. Good. That's good. That's good.
Do you have a motion that goes with that?
No.
You don't have a motion?
No.
Oh, you want me to give you one?
Okay. That's good.
Okay, yeah. That's how you do it. Okay.
Let's see if it's up there making up the bed. Tim, how you doing?
How are you?
What do you do, man?
Mortgage loan officer in North Chicago and also a minister.
A minister?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Well, I was just kidding about the tucking. I'm trying to go to heaven. Really wasn't. That ain't how I tucked the bed. Why don't y'all let me know these things before these people get out here? Jesus. Talking to a man of God. Jesus. Okay. Your relation to him?
This is my uncle.
Okay,
my big,
great.
Uncle.
This is great. Thanks a lot. Appreciate you coming. Okay, great. Pastor, name a household chore. I'm sure you. I don't know how to ask you this. You know, you could just pass it if you want to, you know. We ask 100 married men, name a household chore you'd love to see your wife do in the nude. Mm.
Steve, after we come from church, I love to see her cook Whoa. In the nude.
Cook. Yeah. Yeah. Cooking. Thank you, Pastor. Oof. Top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 married men, name something your wife is holding when she says you've got some explaining to do.
Underwear.
Underwear.
Somebody else's wedding ring.
Somebody else's wedding ring.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
You want to play? You want to play?
We're playing, Steve.
This is not a good question when you're on your third marriage. We asked 100 married men, name something your wife is holding, and she says you've got some explaining to do.
The bank statements.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. The bank statement.
Hi.
We asked 100 married men, name something your wife is holding when she says, you've got some explaining to do.
Cell phone.
Yes. Yes!
Yes, 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 yes. Yes. Sorry if that hit you hard, sorry.
Yes!
I'm sorry, I'm sorry.
Cell phone. Lori, talk to 100 married men. Name something your wife is holding when she says you've got some explaining to do.
Steve, I'm going to say a condom. You got some explaining to do. I got a used condom in my hand. You got some explaining to do. That's right.
Yes!
Condom, baby. Condom.
Box of condoms. Leah, we talked to 100 married men. Name something your wife is holding when she says you've got some explaining to do.
A note with another woman's phone number.
God, dog. Yes! Note with another woman's phone number on it. Adam, 100 married men. Name something your wife is holding when she says you've got some explaining to do.
We can go with some drugs, Steve. Drugs.
Going drugs.
Drugs! We got two strikes. You got to be careful, Dana. Conti family could steal. Talk to 100 married men. Name something your wife is holding when she says you've got some explaining to do.
Shirt with lipstick on the collar.
God, dog. Lipstick! Amy, two strikes. Let's be careful. Conti family can steal.
An email. Yeah.
Email.
An email.
We talked to 100 married men. Name something that wife is holding where she says you've got some explaining to do.
A gun.
Well, if she has the gun, you have some begging to do. That's very different. A gun! Number six. Number five. We asked 100 married men, use a cooking term to describe your sex life.
Hot.
Hot. Brian.
Ice cold.
Sorry, dude. Sorry, man. It's going to pick up for you. Don't worry about it. It's going to pick up for you. Don't even worry about it. I know it's a little tough right now, but we all go through that phase, Brian. It picks up for all of us, man. The pastor went over there and bumped. Hang in there, man. Just as men, Brian, please know we're feeling you, man. And we understand where you are. There's going to be a chick one day. They're going to look at you and go, woo! And it's going to be all the way cracking, man. Please, that's how it works, man. Cooking term describes your sex life. Ice cold.
Yeah! We're up late.
See how it works out for you?
Thank you.
Appreciate the prayer, Pastor. We got top six answers on the board. Oh, my God. This is so wrong on so many levels. Good luck, folks. Here we go. We asked 100 married men, we want the naked truth. What part of your wife's body looks better with clothes on?
Butt.
Her butt. Darius, you said you was a husband, didn't you?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Is she here?
No, she's not here. She's watching. Okay. I got this one.
Darius, sometimes, let me just say this. I ain't saying you ought to do this, but I'm just suggesting. This is just a game we playing here. You have to live with this woman. This might be a time just take an ex.
No.
Okay, all right. We asked 100 married men. That be you. We want the naked truth. What part of your wife's body looks better with clothes on?
Her breasts. But they God, look great no. with the clothes
no,
off,
no,
too.
No, 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 no. See, I told you. I told your ass before you said this. I said, Doug, you need to think good about answer, this before good you answer, say this here.
Good answer. Good
answer. It's up there, Steve.
It better be. I tell you what, you bet. It better be. You better not have said that and it ain't up there. Her breasts. Tiara.
Yes.
Talk to 100 married men. We want the naked truth. What part of your wife's body look better with clothes on?
I would think the stomach.
Yeah, yeah. Good answer. Good answer, Tiara.
Stomach.
Good job. Good job, baby. Good job.
Man, we ask 100 married men. We want the naked truth. What part of your wife's body look better with the clothes on?
Women talk about this all the time, their feet.
Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer. That's a good answer. Hey, Linwood, that's the best answer you can give. Now, that bad boy up there, we cooking with grease. Feet! Come on, Linwood. Win, lose, or draw. You held your own today, Linwood. All right, Miss Yvette, we ask 100 married men the naked truth. What part of your wife's body looks better with clothes on?
I'm going to say her back.
Her back. All right, Chanel, one strike. 100 married men, we want the naked truth. What part of your wife's body look better with clothes on?
Her thighs.
Her thighs. Boy, come on. Yeah, boy, come on. You get this one right here, boy. This one could get you put out the house. One answer left. Clear the board. Talk to 100 married men. We want the naked truth. What part of your wife's body look better with clothes on?
Her arms.
Yeah, you're going to get put out. Top six answers on the board. Ladies, we asked 100 married men, when your wife asks if you think her new girlfriend is pretty, what do you say?
No.
No.
Yes.
Yes. Fellas, listen to me. Number three, don't say that. Your wife asks you her girlfriend pretty, don't your stupid ass say number three. Don't say it, fellas. Kevin,
yes,
talk to 100 married men. When your wife asks you think her new girlfriend's pretty, what do you say?
She's all right.
She's
there
all right.
Go. Good answer.
She all right, yeah. Allison, what do you do?
I'm an elementary school teacher.
And you enjoy teaching?
I love teaching. I love my school. I love my students. I'm at Stevens Elementary in Katy.
There
they
you
are
go.
Really awesome.
There
I
you
love
go. There you go.
Yes.
Woo! Yeah. Ready to play?
Yeah, absolutely.
We asked 100 married men. When your wife asks if you think her new girlfriend is pretty, what do you say?
You are prettier.
Yeah, there
all
you go.
Right.
Yeah. You are pretty. David, all right, we asked 100 married men, when your wife asks if you think her new girlfriend's pretty, what do you say?
You change the subject.
You change the subject. Miss Nancy, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
You're in charge, everybody?
I am.
Yeah.
That's
right. What do you do, Miss Nancy?
Actually, I own my own furniture and floor covering store. We're trying to maybe invent some carpet that you don't get carpet burns for.
Well, what's going on in y'all small town?
Huh? A
How do most people get carpet burns, Miss Nancy?
Sometimes it's the little rubbing on the back end.
Oh, on the back. Oh, you got, oh, so you can get carpet burns on your ass. Yeah, that's it. No, you got carpet burns on your backside. Let me tell you something. That's some aggressive-ass carpet burns right there. All right, darling, you ready to play? Miss Nancy, talk to 100 married men. When your wife asks if you think a new girlfriend's pretty, what do you say?
What girlfriend?
What girlfriend? That's right. What girlfriend? Megan? One answer left, you can clear the board. When your wife, well, 100 men, if your wife asks you, do you think a new girlfriend is pretty, what do you say?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Absolutely nothing.
Hey, fellas, you cannot do that. You have to have a response. You can't say nothing. All right, you ready? I thought that was up there. All right, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. One answer left, you can clear the board, but the Okafor family can steal. Talk to 100 married men. Your wife asks you if you think a new girlfriend's pretty. What do you say?
If you say so.
If you say so. Top seven answers on the board. We ask 100 married men, in heaven, what do you hope to finally get to have all to yourself?
Money.
Money.
Family.
Family. Rondell.
Peace and quiet.
Peace and quiet. Charnice, we talked to 100 married men. In heaven, I'm just say this once to everybody. This is for 100 married men. One time, 100 married men. In heaven, what do you hope you finally get to have all to yourself?
A TV.
TV, all to yourself. Yeah. Date 100 men. You get to heaven, what do you finally hope to have all to yourself?
Like, you know, there's this little man room, like...
See, that's what we're talking about. The man room. That's a man room. A man room. All right, Roger, you probably been wanting to say this to your family for a long time. Your wife is here. The kids is here. You probably ain't never said that to them, because you ain't want to hurt them. But they here. You finally get to have this all to your damn self. Go ahead, Roger.
My own bedroom. All to myself.
I understand what you mean by that. Your own bedroom. Own bedroom.
Good job, Dad.
Shabree, talk to 100 married men. In heaven, what do you hope you finally get to have? All to yourself. This is mine.
Your own bathroom, Steve.
Man. My own bathroom.
Good answer.
That's a big thing.
Good answer. Ready?
One strike. Rondell, you in heaven. What do you hope to finally get to have all to yourself?
My refrigerator.
That's a big boy answer right there. Rondell want his own damn refrigerator. Don't nobody get nothing in here. All this mine, homie. Rondell want his own. All he hams in here, all them hams is mine. Hey, God, when Rondell get to heaven, he want his own refrigerator. Shawnice, 100 married men in heaven, what do you hope to finally get to have all to yourself?
I'm going to go with closet space.
Now, we know that even in heaven, we ain't going to get that, so. Closet space. Well, well, well. Well, look whose turn it is again. Guess we gonna be down here for 5 minutes. Let me go on, take a seat. Watch you play these little reindeer games. We got 2 strikes, Jada. The family can steal. Don't worry, it's gonna be a minute for us. We ask 100 married men in heaven, what do you finally get to have all to yourself? Talk to 100 married men. In heaven, what do you hope to finally have all to yourself?
The silver fox says a recliner. Yeah.
Yeah. The silver fox wants his own lazy boy recliner. Number 6. In heaven? 5. Point value is a double. Boy, y'all gonna get in a lot of trouble on this one. Top 6 answers on the board. We asked 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
Smile. It's up there.
Shut up. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Smile.
I'm gonna say her butt.
Butt. It wasn't a good answer.
I thought it was a good answer.
No, it wasn't a good answer. It wasn't up there.
Answer.
It was nice and safe. That's right. All right, Caitlin, talk to 100 married men. Name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
Her wallet.
Her wallet. Hey, Josh, 100 married men. Name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
I'm gonna say, her breasts.
Good answer. Yeah.
Wait a minute.
Yes.
Ain't this your mother-in-law right here?
Yes, yes, sir, Steve.
How stupid is your ass? Hey, is you nuts? You can't say...
$20,000,
okay, I got
Steve.
You. $20,000, my bad. Hey, John, I forgot, my bad. Brass! All right, Jeff, we ask 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
Her house.
Her house! Nancy, we ask 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
Her mouth.
Her mouth! Her damn mouth!
There you go!
Kyle, only 1 strike, buddy. Talk to 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
She's got a bigger temper.
A bigger temper. Caitlin, we got 2 strikes. We got to be careful. Martin, family can steal. 100 married men. Name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
Her car.
Her car. Hey, Josh, we got 2 strikes. 1 answer left. You can clear the board. We got to be careful. Other family can steal. Name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
Hair.
Hair. That's a good answer. That's a good answer. Hair. That was a good answer. Talk to 100 married men. Name something your mother-in-law has that's bigger than yours.
We're going to go with ego personality.
Ego personality. Number six. Top eight answers on the board. We asked 100 married men, no pressure, but your wife wants you to tell us what her best feature is.
Her smile.
Her smile. Pass the play.
We're playing, Steve.
We're playing this play. Drew, we talked to 100 married men. That's not you. But it should be. No pressure. But your wife wants you to tell us what her best feature is. She's watching. Let's go.
Legs.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yep. Legs.
We got two more. We got two more.
Worst player of all time. This, I actually got to tell you, Drew, that was actually a good answer.
I appreciate it.
Hey, Hallie, we asked 100 married men, no pressure, but your wife wants you to tell us what her best feature is.
Her butt.
Good answer. Yes.
Hey, butt. Mona?
Yes.
We talked to 100 married men, no pressure, but your wife wants you to tell us what her best feature is.
Her hair.
Yep.
Her hair.
Good answer. Yes. Yes.
No pressure.
No.
But your wife wants you to tell us what her best feature is.
Personality.
Okay. All right.
All the beauty. All the beauty, everything else is up there. Mm-hmm. Personality.
See. Drew, this is years of knowledge and experience. Personality. Only one strike, folks. Tiffany, let's just do this. We asked 100 married men, no pressure, but your wife wants to tell you. No pressure, but your wife wants to tell you what her breast feature is.
Her breast.
Her breast. Her breast. Her breast.
Yes. 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 Oh, Jerry Cannon. What a turn. Jerry Cannon.
Drew. We asked 100 married men, for the love of God, no pressure. But your wife wants you to tell us what her best feature is. I got faith in you, Drew. I'm walking over here, I'm gonna point at it.
Her abs, stomach.
Yo, abs. Yeah. Abs.
That's it. It's supposed to be up there.
I can't. This is a movie.
It's supposed to be up there.
This move, I can't make this up. You can't write this script. That should have been up there. That was another good answer. All right, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Olszewski family can steal. Talk to 100 married men, no pressure, but your wife wants you to tell us what her best feature is.
Her hips.
We asked 100 married men, no pressure, but your wife wants you to tell us what her best feature is.
Her intelligence.
Her intelligence. Number seven. Four. Top six answers on the board. We asked 100 married men, name something your wife thinks she does really well, but she doesn't.
Cook.
Cook. Yes. Pass the play.
We gonna play, Steve?
Yeah. I'm very fortunate. My wife, Marjorie, can really cook. She's a country girl. She can really, really
well,
cook.
Well, I can't, Steve.
You can't cook. That's all right, Bridget. Are you married?
To this wonderful, lovely man?
Well.
Ryan cooks well.
He can cook.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to say, somebody cooking at his house. Ryan, you might not can cook, but he eating it. That's a damn show. Ryan got it on there with it.
Yes.
But well, what do you do?
I'm a third grade teacher. I'm an extreme couponer, and I worked at In-N-Out for 10 years.
Yay! You're a third grade teacher.
Third grade teacher.
You a coupon?
Extreme couponer.
Extreme.
Extreme.
Oh, you cut coupon.
Yeah. Guess what I just got?
What you just got?
A washer and dryer. 3-year warranty on both. $1,000.
The guy over there, he going, yeah. All right. Well, let's go. We ask 100 married men, name something your wife thinks she does really well, but she doesn't.
Cleans.
Clean. What do you do, man?
I'm actually a combat veteran, sir.
You're what?
Combat veteran.
Combat veteran. That's good work. Thank you, man. Appreciate your service. What branch of the military?
Army.
Army. Oh, yes, yeah. You was in there.
Yes,
for
sir.
Real.
I served 9 months in Logar Province, Afghanistan.
Afghanistan?
Yes, sir.
Thank you for your service, Ryan. Talk to 100 married men. Name something. Oh, here she is right here. Name something your wife thinks she does really well, but she don't. Uh-oh.
Dance.
Oh, room.
I just saw her do that. I paid $1,000 for the washing machine. Thanks, she can dance. Miss Trina, 100 married men, name something your wife thinks she does really well, but she doesn't.
Laundry.
Laundry. Rihanna, talk to 100 married men, name something your wife thinks she does really well, but she doesn't.
I'm gonna say tell jokes.
Tell jokes. Talk to 100 married men, name something your wife thinks she does really well, but she doesn't.
Have a party.
Have a party. Two strikes. Denise's family can steal. 100 married men, name something your wife thinks she does really well, but she doesn't.
Drive.
Talk to 100 married men, name something your wife thinks she does really well, but she doesn't.
Make love.
Make love. Number six.
Sing.
Four.
Save money.
We asked 100 married men, be honest, you fantasized about using your wife's what?
Body.
Body. Robert.
A car.
Car.
Clothes.
Clothes. Pass the point. Wait. Hannah, what do you do?
So I actually work in the hearing industry. So I help improve people's life, the quality of life, and providing them hearing devices.
So
and Steve, she's single.
Wow, you just thought you'd throw that out there?
I heard about your matchmaking skills, so you know.
I'm pretty good.
I want to help the sister out.
I mean, all you want me to do is find a really nice man.
But that fits her six, no, her what, six S's? I'll let her tell you what that is.
She got six kids?
No, six S's, her requirement, criteria. For that she looks for in a man.
I was gonna say, that hunt just tightened up. So you have the six S's?
No, the six.
The 6'6"?
Yes.
What is it? Just explain what that means.
Six figures?
He has to make six figures.
Uh-huh. 6 inches tall, 6 feet tall?
No, that ain't what you said.
No. That was my third.
That ain't what you said. Clearly, we all heard 6 inches. Oh, you can try to get it back in. Too late. We heard 6 inches. You got the right to want what you want. Okay, so we got six figures, 6 inches feet. We just call that one thing. What else?
6 feet tall.
6 feet tall.
Six pack.
A six pack.
Yes.
And what else?
600 horsepower.
Yeah. Well, you're gonna be by yourself for a while. Women just chuckling me in here going. All right, let's go. Talk to 100 married men, be honest. You fantasize about using your wife's what?
Her brain.
Her brain. All right, D. We ask 100 married men, be honest, you fantasize about using your wife's what?
Makeup.
Okay. Men, we ask 100 married men, be honest, you fantasize about using your wife's what?
Her vibrator.
Let me tell you something, man. You done threw a lot of fellas in here into something with that answer right there. Because there's men in here trying to figure out what the hell's he talking about. The vibrator.
You
got two strikes, got to be careful. The Allen family can still talk to 100 married men. Be honest. You fantasize about using your wife's what?
Girlfriend. Friends.
Good answer. Good answer.
Her girlfriend. Man, be honest. You fantasize about using your wife's what?
Nail polish, Steve.
Nail polish. Number six.
Bold.
Five.
Hair dryer.
Number four. Three.
Razor!
Top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 married men. We asked 100 married men. You just realized you have the winning Super Lotto numbers. What might you do before telling your wife?
Hide it.
Wow. Hide it.
Call the investment person.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Call the investment person. Shamil.
Spend it.
What do you mean, spend it?
Spend it on clothes.
Shamaria.
Shanari.
Shanari.
Go on vacation.
Long vacation. Jim.
Buy a car.
Buy a car.
play.
Pass, play.
Play, play, play.
We'll play. Yeah, we'll play.
Hi, Don.
Hi.
Talk to 100 married men. You just realized you had the winning super lottery ticket. What do you do before you tell your wife?
Divorce her.
Yeah. Divorce her. See, you gotta remember, we asked 100 married men. These, a lot of dudes, 42 dudes out of 100 is leaving her ass immediately. Nate, 100 married men, you just realized you have the winning super lottery numbers. What do you do before telling your wife?
Gonna buy a boat.
Gonna buy a boat. Jameson, you just realized you got the super lotto numbers. What might you do before you tell your wife?
Buy a new TV.
Ooh, well, good answer, good answer.
Buy a new TV. Brady, come on, man. We got two strikes. Got to be careful, buddy. Bussy family can steal. Brady, 100 married men, you just realized you got the winning super lotto numbers. What do you do before you tell your wife?
Spend it at the strip club.
Great answer. That's it.
You have the super lotto. This is hundreds of millions of dollars. Your young ass is blowing it at the strip club. Brady gonna buy a strip club.
All right.
We ask 100 married men, you just realize you have the winning super lottery numbers. What might you do before telling your wife?
Cash it in, Steve.
Cash it in. Number 7. Oh, she gonna find out. Number 5.
Take it in a safe place.
3. Oh, y'all in so much trouble right out the gate. This is a tough one, though. Top 7 answers on the board. We asked 100 married men. That's both of you. Name something you wish your dog could give your wife lessons in.
Being quiet.
Being quiet, yeah. Just don't look over there. You got to go back over there. Be quiet. And it ain't even up there. And it ain't even up there.
Following instructions.
Following instructions. Yep. Bing. Hey, Chris Ann. All right, darling, we talked to 100 married men. Name something you wish your dog could give your wife lessons in.
Rolling over?
Oh!
Oh! Yes! Yeah. Rolling over.
Oh, I wish that's up there. Roll over. Roll over. Courtney, one strike. Talk to 100 married men. Name something you wish your dog could give your wife lessons in.
How about being loyal?
Being loyal. Jenna, talk to 100 married men. Name something you wish your dog could give your wife lessons in.
I'm going to go with walking.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good answer. Good answer.
So you think a man would want his wife to walk like his dog? You don't think we like the way our women walk?
Oh, no, I mean walking with him, alongside him.
Oh. Yeah! Yeah!
Walking! Oh. Jim, how you doing today, man?
I'm all right.
We got two strikes. We got to be careful. Battle family can steal. Talk to 100 married men. Name something you wish your dog could give your wife lessons in.
How to sit down.
How to sit down. Hey, Josh, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. The battle family can steal. 100 married men. Name something you wish your dog could give your wife lessons in.
And the best way I could say is fetching. Fetch me a beer.
Fetch.
Fetch. Fetch. Yeah. Yes, 100 married men. Name something you wish your dog could give your wife lessons in.
Steve, we're going to go with how to sleep.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
How to sleep. Number seven. Six. Four. Number three. Point values are triple. Top four answers on the board. Ladies, here we go. We asked 100 married women, name a specific punishment for men who cheat on their wives.
Doghouse.
Doghouse.
No sex.
No sex.
They're gonna play, Steve?
They're gonna play. Dave, 100 married women, name a specific punishment for men who cheat on their wives.
Okay, okay.
Greg, we ask 100 married women, name a specific punishment for men who cheat on their wives.
Sleeping on the couch.
Sleeping on the couch. All right, we got to pull it together now, family. We got two strikes here. If it's there, you're still alive. If it's not there, the Trust family can steal and play sudden death. Katie, 100 married women, name a specific punishment for men who cheat on their wives.
Show me divorce.
Yeah. Show me divorce. Yeah. All right, Dan, two strikes. If you're there, you're still alive. If it's not there, the other family can steal and play sudden death. 100 married women. Name a specific punishment for men who cheat on their wives.
I'm going to say a physical punishment, like injure them, Steve.
Oh, good answer.
A physical punishment, like injure them. Yeah! Woo! One answer left, Miss Roberta. Yes. If it's there, your family wins the game. But this time, you have two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and play sudden death. 100 married women, name a specific punishment for men who cheat on their wives.
They need to move out.
They need,
yeah,
for the win, move out. All right, guys, here's the situation. One answer, just one answer left. If it's there, your family steals, your family gets a chance to play sudden death. If it's not there, the other family wins the game. One answer, this is it, here we go. We ask 100 married women, name a specific punishment for men who cheat on their wives.
Steve, we're gonna say, give him the silent treatment.
This is for sudden death. The silent treatment. Number two.
Losing.
Top six answers on the board. Ladies, here we go. We asked 100 married men, name someone you'd hate to hear you hit on while you were drunk.
Your wife's mom.
Your wife's mama.
point.
You know, your husband was over here the other night. He told me how cute I was. All right, Jasmine, talk to 100 married men. Name someone you hate to hear you hit on while you were drunk.
Wife's sister.
Your wife's sister. Tanil, we talked to 100 married men. Name someone you'd hate to hear you hit on while you were drunk.
A cousin, Steve.
Cousin. Jane, we talked to 100 married men. Name someone you hate to hear you hit on while you were drunk.
Another man.
Oh! Another man! Oh! All right, Jane, we talked to 100 married men. Now, we got to be careful. We got two strikes, valid dime, family can steal.
Want to say your boss.
Your boss. Nikki, two strikes, Valadon family can steal. Name someone you'd hate to hear. Yeah, you hit on while you were drunk.
Wife's best friend.
Your wife's best friend.
Let's go.
Jasmine, two strikes, other family can steal. Talk to 100 married men. Name someone you'd hate to hear you hit on while you were drunk.
Your children.
Your children. We ask 100 married men, name someone you'd hate to hear you hit on while you were drunk.
Your ex, Steve.
Your ex.